Art Deco is about fantasy and spectacle. Spectacle has the power to suspend disbelief, and it is made more potent if architecture is used as its backdrop. The Manila Carnival was an annual event celebrated during the heyday of the American colonial regime. So, ang Manila Carnival is not only a festivity, but it is an embodiment of Art Deco spectacle. Dito makikita natin na kinukoronahan ang mga Manila Carnival Queens at talagang ito ay pinakabongga nung panahon ng Jazz Age. Kung titingnan natin ang Rizal Memorial ngayon, ang dating kinatatayuan or dating site ng Manila Carnival. So may connection yung dalawang lugar. Pareho silang spectacle ng kagandahan at yung isa ay spectacle ng palakasan. In the second episode of Deco Decoded, we will see how Art Deco becomes a form of spectacle, energized by the vibe and verve of the Jazz Age.
Art Deco's inspiration was always more commercial than aesthetic. The avant-garde also had a strong influence on the development of the Art Deco style, in which the art of French Cubism, Italian Futurism, and Russian Constructivism gave designers a fundamentally new and modern language of forms. Exoticism fueled the quest for a new style from African to South American sources. The discovery of the tomb of Tutankhamun in 1922 stirred curiosity about ancient Egypt. Archaeological work in Mexico awakened interest in the pre-Columbian civilizations. Greek mythology returned to fashion. Motifs, symbols, and imagery from exotic cultures were widely appropriated to embellish jewelry, clothes, and buildings. The exotic was now within reach through the glamour of travel and the novelty of new technology. A reflection of the fascination for adventure and escape. Nowhere else was there such an investment of skills, time, and money into both the development and promotion of this intensely glamorous and escapist style than the fabled Manila Carnivals held annually from 1908 to 1939. Organized by the American colonial authorities to celebrate the harmonious relationship between the United States and its colonial subjects in the Philippines and to highlight the colonial progress in the islands. The two-week festival was held in the grounds of Luneta, with spectacular parades, lavish shows, music and firework displays. The main event was the coronation of the Queen of the Manila Carnival, chosen from among the daughters of the country's most prominent families. Ephemeral grand edifices were erected to sustain the colonial fantasy and splendor. From the imposing Carnival Gate the majestic coronation throne, the expansive hippodrome, to the provincial booths and displays that vied for the spectators' attention. Architects like Tomas Mapua, Carlos Barreto, and Juan Arellano were commissioned to design the overall carnival look and rendered each event in a unique brand of architectural exoticism that is unmistakably Art Deco in sensibility. But nothing had greater importance in Art Deco's worldwide dominance than the films of Hollywood. Cinemas, so often the trailblazers of the new style, also sprang up all over the city. Hollywood lured audiences by selling a shimmering fantasy of glamour that refuses to fade. The craze for Art Deco coincided with the establishment of the ritual of moviegoing as a national pastime, a new type of building, the cinema, was created to enable the public to see films en masse. Art Deco glamour in the building and as portrayed on screen made the style more widespread and accessible. Art directors from the studios used Art Deco to symbolize a sort of glamorous, young, cutting-edge, slightly naughty, and sexy character. In the flamboyant musicals of Fred Astaire and Ginger Rogers, or in films such as Footlight Parade, Grand Hotel, Street, and Gold Diggers of Broadway, a magical web was woven with tales of luxury, youth and beauty, upward mobility, and rampant consumerism. The backdrops for these dreams were fantastic deco-styled hotels, nightclubs, offices, apartments, and skyscrapers. They offered a heady cocktail of modern themes and chic style that proved irresistible to millions worldwide. Hollywood Deco was rapid fire. It roared with the energy of its time, embodying the machine age. The machine is central to the aesthetic of the period. The films of Busby Berkeley are a manifesto of how machine becomes a kind of art and bodies could be synchronized as kaleidoscopic machinery. Remarkably, Hollywood's deco global impact transformed city skylines from New York to Manila and shaped the new pleasure palaces, hotels, cocktail bars, apartments, and cinemas. Perhaps one of the most significant aspects of Art Deco's influence on architecture is that of the skyscraper. As well as a striking symbol of modernity, the spectacle of the towering skyscraper also signifies the impact of the new modern style on the art and lifestyle of America.
Ano lang nangyari sa'yo? Hindi kanya ng pagkanta niyan. Kantahin mo kagaya ng dati.
Bakit niyo ako pinipilit pa kantahin ng English? Sinabi ko na sa inyo hindi ako maaari. Bakit din niyo ako pantahin ng Tagalog?
Oy, alamin mo na tayo nasa Manila. At ang dapat mong kantahin ay English.
In a highly controlled colonial atmosphere, Filipinos crave for escape. Art Deco was absolutely vital for the design of cinemas. Cinemas were built on a grand scale, dispensing ostentatious grandeur. Supremely theatrical, Art Deco provided a fascinating escape which common Filipinos found in the architecture of cinema palaces for the mere price of a ticket. Drawn by the light of a projector, anyone could enter this temple as if he or she were participating in a new religion. With a screen like a vast altarpiece. On it, the American way of life is idealized and constitutes the vicarious experience that converted the Filipinos into little brown Americans. At the heart of every home was the radio, an icon of Art Deco. Radio was a total revolution, a revolution as big as the internet.
We now return you to Carl Phillips at Grover's Mill.
Ladies and gentlemen, here I am, back of a stone wall that adjoins Mr. Wilmer's garden.
It bursts into flames. Get it started. It's rising terrible. All the humanity and all the furniture speeding around it.
Right to the jaw in exchange. Now in the center of the ring, Lewis got a miss with a hard right, and there he pulled the right.
A fiery horse with the speed of light, a cloud of dust, and a hearty hi-yo, Silver, the Lone Ranger.
The 1930s saw an explosion in the use of the new medium, turning the wireless scientific box into an indispensable consumer object, ultimately becoming a stylish piece of domestic furniture.
Thank you.
Nagustuhan niyo bang episode na to? For more updates, subscribe to my channel.